How are you, Margret?
I'm okay, I guess.
How's work going? Are you able to keep up?
Not really good. I'm starting to get fed up.
With what?
Everything. Every time I have to write about the same damn thing. Wall Street went up 150 points, Congress passed another bill, the president's approval rate is below 50%. It all bores me to death.
Haven't you wanted to become a journalist with the Washington Post?
I thought I did. Now it all seems so dull.
What if you were able to quit your job? Say you had the chance to just walk away. You were offered a job, something to interest you. What would you do? I mean, regardless of how much it pays.
An ecologist. Nature has always seemed to be my thing.
Get up.
What? Why?
Jess, get up. Face the other way.
Why? What is this?
Just do it. Come on. Now turn around. Do you trust me?
I don't know. Should I trust a therapist?
No, do you trust me?
Yeah, I guess.
Then fall back. I'll catch you.
What's the point of this?
I need to know if you trust me, because if you don't trust me, there's no sense in me trying to help you. Now turn around or we're finished.
Fine, if it makes you feel better.
This isn't for me. Now fall back. I'm right here. I'll catch you.
I'm sorry, I can't.
Then we're finished here.
No, it's not you. It's just...
You don't trust anyone, right? Do you want to feel better?
Yes.
Then you need to show me.
Can we try something else?
Let's go for a drive.
What are we doing here?
We're just going for a walk. What's wrong with the little exercise? Close your eyes.
Why?
I want to take this blindfold and cover your eyes, and we're going to go on a walk.
Like, this is any better than falling in your arms? No, thank you.
Look, we have to try something. You said you wanted to get better, didn't you?
Yeah, but I just thought we would talk. I didn't think I'd have to fall down and walk blind and all this crap.
Margret, you have to trust me. You have to trust me. I know how to help you. If you keep fighting me all the time on this, I can't guarantee that you're going to feel any different from the first day you met me. You have to let go. I won't let you fall. This scenery is magnificent. I love coming out here on days like this. There's nothing like it. I wish you could see this for yourself.
Jeanne, where are we?
Don't worry. Just breathe in the fresh air.
Seriously, where are we?
Just relax. It's only you and me right now.
Why?
Here. This will help. It's chai tea. It's meant to calm the nerves, and it's full of antioxidants. Are you okay now? Look, I know what you think I did was evil, and really, I don't blame you. Obviously, it brought you back to a terrible time in your life. But the truth is, if you want to get better, it starts by facing what happened to you head on. You have to grab that fear, get a hold of it around its throat, accept that it's there, and then throw it behind you. I know it's easier said than done, but it's not up to me to take that first step.
Two years ago, I was taking my nightly walk through the bike path near my house. I didn't usually see anyone on that path, so I didn't feel anything out of the ordinary. I see this dark figure ahead of me, so I don't really think anything of it. I think I'm just seeing things, I guess. So I kept on walking until I suddenly notice it's a man, a big man, just standing there staring in my direction. I shout him with no response, so I walk the other way. Then I see another man standing on the other side, staring at me. I knew they were after me, so I head into the woods. I ran as fast as I could. I hid behind a tree and reached for my phone to call for help. But I dropped it while I was running. I feel a man's fist strike the back of my head. The next thing I know, One of the men is holding me down, one hand on my back, the other holding my mouth shut. The other man comes up to me and hovers over me. His eyes were filled with hatred. The one man pulls down my pants and starts to rape me, over and over and over again. I'm so exhausted I can't scream anymore, so I just lay there, and they leave. What once was peaceful became my worst nightmare.
They took nothing from you. They pushed the affectionate, trustworthy part of you into a deep, dark hole, but they didn't take it away from you. I'll throw you a rope so you can find peace again. Now, how about you come back tomorrow and we try this again? In the meantime, I want you to find a spot that makes you feel at peace, like a waterfall. I want you to sit, close your eyes, and do nothing.
You mean like meditate?
Yes, exactly.
I've never meditated before.
It's easy. Just focus on your breathing, nothing else. Then I want you to think of something that means the most to you, something monumental. These were given to me by my father many years ago. It was my 10th birthday, and he told me that they would always give me good luck as long as I always did the best that I could with anything that I tried. So whenever I feel worried, anxious, or sad, I take these and I squeeze them, and it helps me to remember that these feelings aren't permanent. And I've had him with me ever since.
I wouldn't know where to go.
What?
You know, to meditate. I can't think of anywhere peaceful.
You do love nature, don't you?
Be strong, Mom.
This is it, Margret. It's time to tell your fear that you're not afraid of it anymore. This is for you. You got this, okay? Thank you.
Lovely view, isn't it? I don't remember it being this beautiful. Ever.
What are you trying to imply?
It's just that, like, I haven't been here in 2 years, that's all.
Yeah, well, 2 years ago wasn't such a beautiful time for me.
Really? Me either. My father made me split firewood for an entire winter. If I didn't split 100 logs by dawn, I didn't get supper. I swear, that asshole wanted me dead. I'm Andrew.
Margret.
So, what do you do, Margret?
I'm an ecologist.
Oh, cool. So, like, nature and organisms, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Cool.
Thank you.